Today, I have another Equal Mana video for you. So today, we are going to talk about chain strategy part in the party setting. The button here, right, it says chain strategy. So let's take a look at here on which one and what that is actually do on this. On the target one, well, you can already guess, right? The closest target enemy for the melee player and put on same enemy as player for those following up when you are taking the lead. Well, but this is depend on what you actually want to do at that time, so I will not talk about it much. It's already has clear by itself. What I'm going to focus here is about the tactic. You can see it here, right? Balance, damage dealer, support and healer. But actually, do you know what does it do? So basically, actually this doesn't really change AI in any way, but it actually will lock the ability out. This only talk about the MP ability, by the way. So if you put balance, it means that this character can spend MP on any of the skill they have. However, if you put on damage dealer, it means that they will only use MP on the damage skill, basically those any attack skill. For support, same but the different. It will only use the skill that is related to support, for example, buff and debuff. Most of the 4-star character come with one buff, but the only character now that can debuff is the 2-star character, the Julius, I think. He can debuff spirit from the monster. And lastly, healer. Well, this one is clearly, you know that if you don't want your healer to spend MP on anything else other than heal, then click this one. The thing though is that this doesn't change AI in any way. So it means that the AI still be able to, AI will still be stupid as long as it go with melee weapon such as Angela or Charlotte. They will still go close in and fight enemy and using the melee range tech on the enemy. So that part will never change. But at least you can control their MP cost. So let's go for the balance first and see how does my AI will do. Let's go. The state we are farming today is the highest difficulty of the mana board for light element. So let's use this state as a test. And you can see that they begin the fight with the buff, right? This is good thing when you put everyone on the balance. Then it means that they can use every skill and yep, they will kill it critically using buff. And using damaging skill. However, you can see that because they cannot be moving when they are using buff, so sometimes this high up draw deck. And you can see that Reed actually use the buff at the front of enemy and taking hit. So sometimes we don't want that, and we might as well go with the damage dealer setting so that she will keep attacking and not buff at enemy front only. You can see that this automatically sweep out when she's nearly die. This happens either when the is out of MP or nearly out of HP. They will sweep out the unit, but this only apply when the unit on the back row is actually as strong as the unit on the front row. So you can see that Duran and Sumo will never switch out because their sub suck. But my Angela is strong. So when Liz is near dead, we switch out and let Angela in. Now what we can check on the next one to make things different. So this time I decided I do not want Liz to buff at enemy front anymore, so I decided to put her as the main villain. Same with Angela, because I know that Angela do that also. So I go with the med dealer also. As for Sumo, actually his buff is really good and his healing are good too. If he use buff, he will not get interrupt when he heal. However, sometimes he use the buff when the friend is almost die. So at this one, I think Balan may be the good choice, but I will try healer so that he will not use MP on anything else and make more chance for him to heal at the right timing. Because Sumo as an AI, actually AI in this game only heal when your unit has below 50% HP. So basically, if your unit doesn't have much defense and enemy can 2-3 shot you, it means that when you already below 50%, if the AI not heal you instantly, or if the AI waste time on buffing, your unit might suffer from it. So in this case, I try to change the setting to healer only, and well, let's see the difference. Now you can see that no unit actually buff at the beginning anymore. Currently only Duran set at Balan because I want him to use the super armor buff to make him die with Liz. But Liz will go with more offensive now, and sometimes when she is doing more damage skill at the front, it could think enemy and give more chance to attack. My Charlotte is so weak, she heal only 300. You can see here that is good and bad. With no buff, majority of the fight I think this is better though, but in this case, in this state, you see that because this close in attack can never fin this enemy with armor. So it turned out that this is a bad option. Alright, I will just use this and then this fight so I don't get my stamina. Again, you can see the difference now, right? That it's between buff and no buff. So it depends on the mission. If some of the mission where you can pin enemy, you can keep attack using damage dealer low is better. But for that mission where enemy is fully super armor and counter your attack, maybe stay far and buff so you have less close in, might be a better choice. Next, we will go try this again, but this time we will put Duran on the head. Because why? Because this. You can see that despite my Duran has a lot lower power than Liz because I have less upgrade him, his con is 1000 something. At the meantime, this is only 800. So at this point, actually, Liz is poor arm character, so she can attack from behind. Dulan is the one who actually need to up close. So basically, put Dulan at front is the better strategy. We will see the difference here. Because the unit in first position in this game is the consider leading unit. So basically, if you put the tank at the front, he's likely to be before anyone else. Do you notice or not that the party actually performed better as it should be? But Dulan AI somehow like to buff at the end of the fight with Kinda Yusuf. Sumo at healer position is doing himself a good job. Stay behind. Dulan can't take it anymore. He got healed, so it's leave out to Andrea. But anyway, you can see that it's improved a lot on the formation, right? So yeah. Okay, to wrap this up. So you basically want to have your leading unit as the one who can take the most hit. Close lane combatter with super high armor would do good here. Play they actually use the buff before battle though. Next, we were talking about strategy low setup. I think Balan is probably okay for majority of the characters, unless you find them annoying to buff at the enemy front and taking hit. Then yeah, you may want to assign specific low for them. So that's all for me. If you like my content, please do me a favor to support me with like and subscribe. Thank you and goodbye.